Hi, next up, we're going to talk low code. We're going to continue our low code conversation. We're going to talk about Oracle Apex and low code. And specifically, we're going to talk about the Oracle Apex Application Development Service, which is brand new from Oracle. And so the Apex service has multiple benefits. And so one of the benefits is low code development. So with the Apex low code development platform, you can build applications more rapidly than you could if you hand coded them. And additionally, you can have them developed by a broader range of developers. You can have citizen developers, lines of business developers, professional developers, sort of the whole gamut. And where the Apex service really shines is that the Apex service is built on autonomous infrastructure. So what that means is that you as an application developer don't have to worry about the deployment of the application. The application is deployed on this fully managed autonomous infrastructure. So it's not of your worry, you don't need to have a DBA. You build your application and you deploy it on autonomous. Another distinguishing characteristics of the Oracle Apex application development service is that it's lower cost than other ways you can get the Oracle Apex. And so what Oracle has done is they've put Apex development front and center with this new Apex development cloud service. It's $358 per month, and which is fully elastic. And so you can scale independently the storage and the compute power. So the compute starts at $240 per month, and you can have it auto scale. You can turn it off if you don't want to pay, if you don't need it for night, or maybe it's a development or test system that's not being used. You can turn that off, and then you can scale the storage as well to petabytes. And so it's really quite capable. It can scale from like a small departmental use case to a large mission critical application, maybe even to millions of users. 128 CPUs is a lot. And so what's different about the Oracle Apex service versus Oracle Apex in autonomous database? And so when you get autonomous database, you have a database experience. When you go to the cloud console, you click on database and you see a database console. The Apex service reverses it. So it's not a database. It just happens to have an Apex application development a framework within it. It is an Apex application development framework targeting developers that just happens to have an Oracle database in it. So when you launch on the cloud service, either for free or paid, an Apex service, you get Apex. You get Apex screens. You see your console is Apex centric. You're just a click away to get the database console if you want that, but it is focused on the developer, focused on the Apex low code developer specifically. Now, there is a difference. The lower cost is because that the Apex service is pretty much identical to the full autonomous transaction processing service, with the exception of the user experience, which I just mentioned, but also that you get SQLNet. So with the autonomous database, you can get SQLNet, you can connect through JDBC, connect through Python driver or something like that. But with the Oracle Apex, since Apex doesn't use SQLNet, it connects over HTTPS, do not need it to run Apex apps. And therefore, Oracle is able to provide the Apex server on autonomous database at a lower cost. Okay. So Apex is all about low code, and this is from Wikipedia. This is my favorite definition of low code. It kind of gets all the core things that I think are most relevant. It broadens the types of developers who can be productive and build out applications. It reduces the time, it reduces the expense, and it really is changing how applications are built across the world. And so let's take a look at this. So there's almost all use cases for low code are addressable. All use cases that you might need in your department or your enterprise. So you might want to extend applications. You might need modernize a legacy system. You might need to build a new system from scratch. You might build a custom system just for your department. You might build a system that's just kind of temporal, just for a month. You might build a system that you want to last for 10 years. Could be enterprise scale, could be just for you personally, could be for your work group. So there's a wide variety of use cases for low code. And what low code, because you can build the applications more rapidly, you you can create perhaps more sophisticated and compelling components than you would be capable of coding by hand, maybe because you're not the world's best programmer, or you don't have every programming skill, you know, you're just not a genius, then Apex can help that from a low code perspective. So let's talk about the broader types of developers. So traditionally, your applications are built by IT people that are professional developers. They build applications day and night. That's what they do. And so new with low code and how low code is used is that it's so easy to use that lines of business developers can use it. Citizen developers can use it. Data scientists can use it. So there's more developers that come there. And so, but these other developers, they bring other perspectives. The line of business developer has deadlines and the line of business in mind when they're building their application. They have knowledge of that line of business that might be harder to transfer to a professional developer that might not be in that line of business. Likewise, with citizen developers, people are more tech savvy than they used to be, and they use social media and they use e-commerce, and they can leverage those skills to build out applications and to build out innovations within their companies and address the types of problems and digitization that can benefit their companies. And that's where this application development and low code thing really kicks in. So what Oracle did is we contracted a firm to do a time and motion study. So we took an accomplished React developer. React is the industry standard JavaScript development framework. So that is your benchmark sort of high control coded solution. And we asked them to build a typical application with various screens. And the development time for someone who is very skilled in React versus Oracle Apex was substantial. So it was 38 times faster for someone that knew React well to create the similar functionality to what you could do with Apex. And likewise, the line of code, there was far less code that was required in the Apex solution than was required in the React solution. So this shouldn't come as a surprise. And if you're interested in the details, we publish it on the link below. So Oracle Apex is all about this productivity. And one of the ways it gets this productivity is it provides it allows you to build your entire app just in your browser. It's not just an application developer, it's a lot of things. It allows you to build your data models. It allows you to create REST and consume REST APIs. It allows you to have a task list that allows you to solicit input from your users during testing and such to see if they like your application or if they have feedback for you, if they're experiencing problems. And of course, it allows you to build your application in low code. So having one tool and one cloud service makes it very easy because there's not this integration. You don't have to learn different user interfaces or different identity management. It's all just one experience. So let's look at part of that experience. So frequently when you create applications, if you're not just consuming REST APIs, which you might do, but frequently you're going to have local tables, and you can create your local tables, stored procedures to store your business logic, et cetera. And you can do that in the SQL Workshop, which comes with Oracle Apex, just a click away. And in fact, if you have a table and you want to create an application on it, you just click a single button, you can create an application on that. A great way to get started. You can look at your tables, add new tables, create views, create all the database components. You can do data modeling, data generation, a lot of power here. When it comes to the application development typically starts with a wizard where you're just going to follow a wizard. Say, I want to create an application, and you click on add a few pages, choose some features, choose a user interface to start with that which you can customize from there. And then once you have your application, you can add additional pages, remove pages, and develop it in this rapid low code style. So Oracle Apex lets you build this application very easily. And you can see these screens are pretty straightforward. So for example, if I wanted to build this faceted search, which is on the left, I could do so using declarative, no code. So the general philosophy is use no code when you can and only use code as an exception. And when you do need to use code, try to use as little code as possible. Maybe just a little snippet of code, maybe just a little bit of business logic, maybe a little bit of SQL. And so the Apex is particularly good at this, and it can let you build out these rich components by just setting properties. And what's interesting is that when I work with developers, I've done so for my entire career, is that if you hand code things, people don't like or find it hard sometimes to edit other people's code because they code in a different style. They think in different ways. They modularize their code differently. Maybe they indent differently. They name their variables differently. But with low code, it's just properties. So when you're setting a property of whether you want to show the counts or how you want to sort your facets, there is no difference between developer one and developer two. So another distinguishing characteristics of Oracle Apex is the architecture. And so as we said, Oracle Apex service, the architecture is fully managed. So the middle tier is fully managed and the database is fully managed. But what's unique about Oracle Apex is it puts the application engine in the autonomous database itself. So the Oracle database includes the Apex engine, which provides a lot of benefits, performance benefits, as well as high availability benefits. And so let's drill down into some of those. So specifically, because Apex is not a code generator, it's a model-driven execution engine, which means it generates data from metadata stored in the Oracle database. Oracle database is really good at storing data. And so when customers make requests from their web pages to Oracle Apex, the request can be serviced. Lots of different business processes can be invoked. Screens can be developed and rendered. And because it's in database, you don't have to do any network traversing. You don't have to traverse a network from mid-tier to the database tier, then back to the mid tier, then back to the database tier. You're all in the same computer and the same memory structures on the same server. And it is kind of counterintuitive, but it does provide substantially faster performance. Also interesting about Oracle Apex is that it's available in different ways. So you can get Oracle Apex on-premise. You can get Oracle Apex on-premise for free with Oracle XE, our Express Edition database. You can do your development on-prem and deploy it in the cloud. You can do your development on the cloud and deploy on-prem. You can deploy on-prem, and then when your company moves to the cloud at a later date, you can deploy there. You can deploy your Apex apps on the Oracle cloud. You can deploy your Apex apps on third-party clouds. And so there's a lot of opportunities with Oracle Apex. You can build Apex on Windows. You can build Apex on Linux. You can build Apex in a VM inside of a Mac OS on Linux. So having this option gives you a lot of options for the future. Apex is Apex no matter where you are, but you can have it hosted in different ways. So since Apex lives in the Oracle database and Oracle Apex is able to natively interface with the data structures within an Oracle database, for example, the SQL language, it also takes advantage of the converged nature of the Oracle database. So all the applications I've been building in the last few years have all been what we call converged. In other words, they have multiple different types of data. So for example, where the applications we're building for this COVID pandemic, they all have a spatial component, where you get your vaccination, where you live, et cetera, where is the closest pharmacy, et cetera. And so you might have a text component. Maybe there's JSON documents. Maybe you need to do some analytics. Maybe you need to do other technologies. And what's nice is the Oracle database comes with that built in. So Oracle Apex, it's used a lot. Over 500,000 developers, millions of applications are created, over 6,000 applications are created every day. We've got lots of partners. It runs on mobile. This is a live application in Ghana that's been used by over 73,000 people to get vaccinated. It's quite exciting and really interesting technology. And if you want to learn more, I strongly encourage you to go to apex.oracle.com and you can view our tutorials and videos. So that's it. The Oracle Apex application development service, lower cost, more developer focused. That's the Oracle Apex application development cloud service. There's a lot more information on apex.oracle.com.